with these trumped up charges. I have nothing to fear. I've served, and I've served to the best of my ability, and I will continue to do so without fear or favor. And I'm proud of the family I come from. We will defend this. We'll defend everything that they throw before us, because we believe in what we did. We did it with honesty, integrity, and with the condition, the only condition we did it with was in service to the people of this country.
That was former Housing Minister Irfan Ali moments after stepping out of the courtroom at the Georgetown Magistrates Court this morning. Ali told reporters that he is confident in the country's judicial system and that he would be vindicated of the 19 charges of conspiracy to defraud the state.
During my tenure, with the help of staff and the PPP civic government, we have distributed more than 100,000 house lots and regularized lots. So maybe it should have been 100,000 charges then for every house lot that is given. But I believe firmly in justice. I believe in trusting the Creator and understanding that no wickedness, no form of wickedness, no form of political victimization, no form of this pressure that the government believes they can bring on us, to silence democracy, to silence free speech, to silence an opposition that is exposing them, it would not work. We are solid. This has made me stronger. I am more resolute.
The former housing minister was arrested sometime around 4:30 this morning at his residence by a van load of ranks and taken down to the headquarters of the Special Organized Crime Unit, SOCU, where the sleuth of charges was instituted hours before his arraignment. Ali was represented by a battery of lawyers in court, including former Attorney General Anil Nandlal, who explained one of the grounds on which they plan to defend their case.
Based upon what I have read, it does not appear to be a charge that is known to law. Conspiracy to commit fraud is a charge. What they are particularizing as facts to support that charge do not amount to that charge.
Meanwhile, attorney at law Priyamanik Chand told media operatives earlier that the PPP will be fighting this act of oppression by the coalition government against Ali, who is set to kick off the opposition's debate on the 2019 budget next Monday.
This will be met with lawful but equal force. So this kind of oppressive behavior that the government is engaging in right now, which is to lock up members of the opposition, charge and or lock up members of the opposition, attempt to intimidate members of the opposition by doing these kinds of actions, that it's not going to work. It's not going to intimidate us. It's not going to stop us from representing the people of Guyana with passion and with force and with gusto. And we promise the people of Guyana that this is just a bit of a distraction, not for us, for the government.
Last year, several former government officials under the PPP, including former President Bart Jagdeo, were summoned for questioning on the purchase of lands located at Sparren Dam, East Coast Demerara, commonly known as Prattville 2. The coalition administration is contending that the acquisition of lands in the area by former government officials is a criminal act since it was sold below the market value. Reporting for Earth Evening News, Vanu Manikchand.